बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, वेलकम टू अल्ट्रा फिजिक्स। स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेज वीडियो लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट अल्फा डीके, अल्फा टनलिंग मॉडल, थ्योरी ऑफ अल्फा डीके एंड इट्स प्रैक्टिकल एप्लीकेशंस। सो स्टार्टिंग आवर टुडेज लेक्चर, व्हाट इज अल्फा डीके? इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ रेडियो एक्टिव डीके इन विच एन एटॉमिक न्यूक्लियस emits an alpha particle and thereby decays into an atom with a mass number that is reduced by 4 and an atomic number reduced by 2. A general reaction is shown for alpha decay when a parent nuclei decay into daughter nuclei. Its atomic number decreases by 2 and atomic mass decreases by 4, resulting in the emission of alpha particles. Practical applications: we have a uranium isotope, it decays into thorium with the emission of alpha particles, means helium nuclei. The half-lives of heavy elements which emit alpha particles varies from about 10th of a microsecond to 10 billion years. This half-life range depends strongly on the observed alpha kinetic energy, which varies from about 4 to 9 mega electron volt. This extraordinary dependence upon kinetic energy suggests an exponential process and is modeled by quantum mechanical tunneling through the Coulomb barrier. And the behavior of alpha kinetic energy is shown in the image. Alpha tunneling model. The figure shown represents an attempt to model the alpha decay characteristics of polonium-212. Which emits an 8.78 mega electron volt alpha particles with a half-life of 0.3 microseconds. The Coulomb barrier energy is about 26 mega electron volts, so by classical physics it can't escape at all. Quantum mechanical tunneling gives a small probability that the alpha can penetrate the barrier. To evaluate this probability, the alpha particle inside the nucleus is represented by a free particle wave function subject to the nuclear potential. Inside the barrier, the solution to the Schrodinger equation shows exponential decay. Calculating the ratio of the wave function outside the barrier and inside and squaring that ratio gives the probability of alpha emission. Theory of alpha decay. First theorized by 1928, George Gemow was a scientist who has solved the theory of alpha decay via tunneling. The alpha particle is trapped in a potential well by the nucleus. Classically, it is forbidden to escape, but according to newly discovered principles of quantum mechanics, it has a tiny probability of tunneling through the barrier and appearing on the other side to escape the nucleus. So Gemow solved a model potential for the nucleus and derived from first principles a relationship between the half-life of the decay and the energy of the emission, which had been previously discovered empirically. Now it's a wave function. You can see alpha particles in the nucleus. Relationship: a representation of alpha particle as a wave function, the amplitude of which decreases behind the Coulomb barrier after the tunneling through it. To explain the tunneling of alpha particles through the Coulomb barrier, we can solve the same but more simple problem for the one-dimensional uniform step barrier. Here is shown on the screen. We have a one-dimensional uniform step barrier and the wave function for written is. The solution of the Schrodinger equation is given by the equation. The wave function is a solution of the Schrodinger equation for x less than 0, for x greater than a, and 0 divided by a. The barrier penetration coefficient d represents the decay of intensity of alpha particles wave over the barrier region. The solution has the same form for any other barrier. The potential energy of the alpha particle in Coulomb barrier is given by the relationship, and the barrier penetration coefficient is given as. If alpha decays takes place to or from an excited state, the angular momentum of alpha particle may equals to different values limited by the nuclear size, where lambda, alpha and L less than or equal 10 are the de Broglie wave of the alpha particles and the orbital moment respectively. It leads to the increase of the total potential barrier due to the additional component, angular momentum barrier of the alpha particle. The barrier penetration coefficient D depends on the both barriers. The following approximation can be used for the range of orbital moment. It's a comparison of Giger-Nettle relation with experimental data for different families of nuclei. In this plot, the straight lines confirm the exponential dependence of half-life on energy. We have a different families of nuclei like radium, uranium, polonium. The decay constant lambda is proportional to the barrier penetration coefficient as follows, where P is the probability of the formation of alpha particle in the nucleus and mu is the frequency of the interactions of alpha particles with the nucleus walls. The theoretical prediction of the decay constant has the same form as the empirical law of Giger and Nutter. The odd nucleon alpha emitters, especially in ground state transitions, decay at a slower rate than that suggested by the simple one-body theory. The decays of the odd nuclei are referred to as hindered decays, and a hindrance factor may be defined as the ratio of the measured partial half-life to the calculated one. The hindered decays can be explained by the detailed quantum mechanical analysis of the formation of alpha particles in the nuclei with different energies and orbital momentum. Let's discuss the practical applications of alpha decay. Alpha particle sources are used in variety of practical applications like in energy, medical applications are in the field of science and in industry as well. In energy, so in energy, nuclear battery is a device which uses energy from the decay of a radioactive isotope to generate electricity. Compared to other batteries, they are very costly but have extremely long life and high energy density. And so they are mainly used as power sources for equipment that must operate unattended for long periods of time, such as they are used in spacecraft, pacemakers, underwater systems, and automatic scientific stations in remote parts of the world. First industrial batteries were developed in 1954. Alpha decay also have its application in the field of medicines. Alpha particles emitted by isotope of radium having half-life 11.4 days, for example, can be directly injected in tiny quantities into tumorous tissue to directly irradiate and kill cancer cells. An excellent medical use of an alpha emitter. Since they are not very penetrating, there is less chance of damaging healthy cells. This is an example of internal radionuclide therapy. Students, at the last of lecture, here are some references for you to further study. In today's lecture, we discuss the alpha decay, tunneling model of alpha decay, theory of alpha decay, and also we discuss the practical applications. Student, if you like this video, kindly subscribe my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.